Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our virtual classes. Students, today I have come up with a new concept. My dear students, viewers, and all my dear well-wishers, you have gone through and seen my video on meditation. Today I am presenting a video on how to read. Students, we are all busy preparing ourselves for exams, unit tests, semesters, and hence we are facing examination nervousness, panic, examination fear, phobia, etc., etc. Now this video will help you how to read and prepare yourself for your exams. You can also apply this trick when you are reading newspapers, magazines, storybooks, whatever. So I begin my explanation with this quote. Reading is to mind what exercise is to body. Just as exercising is important for our body to stay fit and mind, reading is an exercise that you do to your brain. I want you to observe this image carefully, students. This is a pie diagram image. Observe this image for 5 minutes. You can pause your video and just observe this image and capture it in the camera of your mind. Try to record somewhere in your mind. And once you have seen this image, students, then you can apply the tricks that I'm trying to show you through this video. While you're reading a novel or storybook also, you can apply the same reading workshop schedule. Now, first thing, choose a book of your choice. Look at this diagram. The first step is saying select a book of your free choice. Right now you're going to select the book on which you are going to read and prepare yourself for the exams. So let us say you're studying lesson tides in geography. So you're going to prepare the open your textbooks, geography textbooks on lesson tides, and silent reading of 10 minutes is what you will be doing it. First 10 minutes silence reading, 3 minutes write about the book. Write about the book, you will be writing whatever concept you read on lesson tide. Students, when I'm saying you to read it, I mean, I do not mean that you are supposed to read the full textbook. Even if you read one page, it's sufficient for me. So, take the first page of lesson tides, read it silently in your mind for 10 minutes, 3 minutes write about the book. Moving back to this image, 2 minutes transit meeting area. 2 minutes moving from the room where you are sitting and reading to the place where your parent or your teacher is there. So 2 minutes from moving to a room from where your parents and teacher is there. And there you will speak about what you have read. Then 10 minutes reading a mini lesson. Mini lesson, you can say we are talking about lesson tides, so you will be reading half the lesson maybe. Half the chapter of it, only just a concept of high tide and low tide. Just read that much. That is mini reading of the lesson. 10 minutes read and discuss a mini lesson. The part of the chapter from where you have studied. And last and not the least, in 24 minutes you'll finish reading the entire lesson. Yeah, 24 minutes read the entire lesson. Last 5 minutes end up with a small revision. Now students, time is not a restriction. Like 10 minutes silent reading I told. Instead of 10, if you take 15 minutes for silent reading, it's okay. Write a talk about the book 3 minutes and 2 minutes transit area. Even if this time extend, it's okay. So you followed what I'm trying to say. Time is not a restriction. I am not asking you to read the full portion for your unit test. Even one page. You know, first you apply only on one page of your textbook, and gradually once you build this habit, you will be able to apply this whole trick on entire syllabus of yours. Now what is close reading? Again we come back to geography and lesson tides. Reading a text multiple times is really very important to understand it. Now say we are talking about lesson tides. Read that textbook at least 3 times. So you're going to read the chapter tides 3 times. Read it with a purpose. Right now, what is your purpose? Your purpose is your exams. So you're reading with a purpose to prepare yourself for your exam. Annotate the text. What is annotate the text? Here I have given you the glossary. Clearly express the main idea from the text. Now what is the main idea? The main idea is we have to understand the concept of tide. So once you read, you try to express the concept of tides. Then talk about the text. Now what are you going to talk about the text? Definitely the chapter that you are reading. Now let's say you are reading a lesson on air pressure. So you are going to talk about air pressure. You are reading the lesson on location of a particular place. The earth, the sun, the moon. That's it. Second lesson in geography. So talk about the text. Whichever chapter you are reading, talk about the text. The next step. Learn new vocabularies. Learn new words. What new words you learned in the lesson air pressure? What new words you learned in the lesson tides? So make a list of new vocabularies. If possible, keep a dictionary handy with you so that you can search for the words that you are not familiar with. Gather evidence from the text and use that evidence. Again, look at the glossaries over here. Gather evidence from the text means collect information. What are you going to collect information on? You're going to collect information on lesson tides. You're going to collect information on lesson air pressure. Gain knowledge about it. Learn the correct pronunciation, which new words you came across. Learn to pronounce them correctly. Learn new vocabulary. Learn new meanings. What new meanings you learned? The word tide was new for you. What is the meaning of the word tide? The word air pressure was new to you. What is the meaning of the word air pressure after you've understood the lesson? And last but not the least, summarize it to answer your question. Whatever you have read it, students, summarize it in your own words. Forget the grammar, forget this other aspects of your language skills, and just try to summarize it so that you can answer your questions well in your exams. All the best. Are you ready for your exam, students? I hope this will be beneficial for you. Thank you.